Problem 5. Six children are evenly spaced around a circular table. Initially, one has a pile of n greater than 0 sweets in front of them, and the others have nothing. If a child has at least 4 sweets in front of them, they may perform the following move. Eat one sweet and give one sweet to each of their immediate neighbours and to the child directly opposite them. An arrangement is called perfect if there is a sequence of moves which results in each child having the same number of sweets in front of them. For which values of n is the initial arrangement perfect?
Okay, so I'm going to call these children A, B, C, D, E and F so that we can talk about them easily. And it'll be child A who starts with the sweets. Clearly, they need to start with at least 4, otherwise we can't do anything. Now, if A performs a move, that means they eat one, and the other 3 get shared out like this. And if A just started with 4, then we're now stuck. We can't do anything else. If we want to be able to do something else, then one of B, D, or F need to have at least 4 sweets. So let's try with A starting with 16, and that means that we will end up, after 4 moves, with 4 here, 4 here, and 4 here. And now we could have F performing a move. We get this, and D eating one, sharing out the remaining ones, and B eating one, sharing out the remaining ones, and we end up with a configuration like this. Now, if only B, D, and F had had more sweets, then we might have ended up with them all equal. In fact, B, D, and F would need 3 more sweets each, and we could accomplish that if we started with 28. So if we started with 28 at A, and then A performed the move 7 times, B, D, and F would each have 7 sweets, and then we could do the 3 moves that we just did. So F perform a move, B perform a move, D perform a move. We'd get these 3 as we just did, but there would be 3 remaining at F, 3 remaining at B, and 3 remaining at D, and we'd have 3 at every single child's place as required. Now we could do that sequence of moves a multiple number of times. So the number 28 works, but also any multiple of 28 works. It's worth noting that there appears to be a little bit of symmetry here. We couldn't have B performing a move without D and F also performing a move. And it seems like the children fall into 2 groups, and I've colour-coded them here to show that. So I've made a table to show how the numbers of sweets change. When child A performs a move, A loses 4 sweets. B gains 1, D gains 1, and F gains 1. When child B performs a move, B loses 4 sweets, but A, C, and E gain 1, and so on. If we work down the columns, we see how many sweets a particular child has. A starts with N, they lose 4 a few times, they might gain 1 here, gain 1 here, and gain 1 here. Now, we're not going to worry about the order in which the moves are performed, but it's very important that we know how many times they were performed. So let's say that A, child A, performs their move small a times. And child B performs their move small b times, and so on. And now let's look down each column and see how the number of sweets change. So child A starts with n sweets. And in some order, they lose 4a, they gain b, they gain d, they gain f, and they end up with k. Okay, this looks promising. We might find something from this. Let's carry on working. So let's look at child B now, who starts with no sweets and gains A, loses 4B, gains C, and gains E, also ends up with K. I've got 2 equations, but I can't see quite yet how I'm going to use these. I'm going to carry on and look at child C. Again, starts with nothing, gains B, loses 4C, gains D and gains F and finishes with K. This is more interesting now because this equation here and this equation here have a lot of similarities. We've got the B, the D and the F in both, and we've got they both equal K, so we can have them both equal to each other. N minus 4A plus B plus D plus F is equal to B minus 4C plus D plus F, and that gives us that N is equal to 4A minus 4C, or just 4 lots of A minus C, and we see that our value of N has to be divisible by 4. So we noted before that these children seem to split into two groups. It seems like A, C and E group together naturally, and B, D and F form the other group. So this time, instead of adding up just one column at a time, I'm going to look at the columns underneath A, C and E all together. Well, if I consider those three children, they start with a total of N sweets, and they lose 4A, they lose 4C, and they lose 4E, but they gain 3B, 3D, and 3F, and they finish with 3K. And now if I do the same for the children B, D, and F, they start with no sweets, they lose 4B, they lose 4D, they lose 4F, and they gain 3A, 3C, and 3E, and that also finishes as 3K. And because they both equal 3K, we can equate these. And rearrange this to give that N is equal to 7A, 7C plus 7E, minus 7B, minus 7D, minus 7F. But obviously, N is divisible by 7. So putting this all together, we've seen that multiples of 28 work. We also have that the number of sweets required for a perfect arrangement must be divisible by 4 and must be divisible by 7. And therefore, the answer is all of the multiples of 28 and only the multiples of 28.